Dear students, this is the second lecture on problem solving regarding wave mechanics. In this lecture, we will solve some of the problems on Heisenberg's uncertainty principle as well as one-dimensional square wave potential. Let us solve first problem. A microscope using photons is employed to locate an electron in an atom to within a distance of 0.1 angstroms. Calculate the uncertainty in the momentum of the electron located. This question is asked in the year May 2018. Let us solve this problem. According to Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, it is impossible to measure both position and momentum of a particle simultaneously with arbitrary precision. And the product of the uncertainties in the position and the momentum is always greater than a quantity of order greater than or equal to h cross divided by 2, that is delta x into delta px is greater than or equal to h cross by 2, where delta x is the uncertainty in measuring position of a particle at certain instant whenever the momentum is measured accurately, and delta px is the uncertainty in momentum we get while we measure position with accuracy. Product of these two is always greater than or equal to h cross divided by 2. In this problem, we are asked to find out uncertainty in the momentum of the electron located. That is, we have to find out delta px. Delta x is given as 0.1 angstroms, where h cross is equal to h divided by 2 pi. Substituting h 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 and divide it by 2 into 3.1418, we will get h cross value as 1.0545 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. Given that delta x is equal to 0.1 angstroms, we know that angstroms is 10 power minus 10 meter. Therefore, delta x becomes 0.1 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Now, uncertainty in the momentum of the electron located is given by delta px is greater than or equal to h cross divided by 2 delta x. We have got this equation by rearranging the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Now I will remove greater than or equal to symbol and I will choose it as nearly equal to. Then delta px is nearly equal to h cross divided by 2 delta x. Substituting the values of h cross and delta x discussed above, we will get the value of delta px as 5.2728 into 10 power minus 24 kg meter per second. Since delta px is the momentum. Momentum has a dimensions of product of mass and velocity. We have unit of delta px is kg meter per second. Also, we can choose the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle in this way. That is, delta x into delta px is nearly equal to h cross. Here I have taken h cross by 2 instead of h cross. H cross by 2 tells us that it is the minimum uncertainty product. Let us solve second problem. A sodium atom has lifetime 1.6 into 10 power minus 8 second in the excited state. It goes to the ground state by emitting a photon of wavelength 589 nanometer and corresponding energy 2.105 electron volts. What is the uncertainty in energy of excited state? What is the wavelength spread of the corresponding spectral line? Now we will solve this problem using Heisenberg's uncertainty principle for energy and time uncertainty product. That is given by delta E into delta T is nearly equal to h cross. That is, this relation connects the uncertainty delta E in the determination of energy of a system with time interval delta t available for the energy determination. Since we are asked to find out uncertainty in energy, we can rearrange this equation in the form delta E is nearly equal to h cross divided by delta t. If we choose or if we want to calculate minimum uncertainty, we have to replace h cross by 2 on the right hand side of this equation. Then we will get delta E as h cross divided by 2 delta t. Then we can find out minimum uncertainty in measuring delta E, where h cross is equal to 1.054 into 10 power minus 34 joule second. We have calculated this in the previous example. We will list out the given data now. Sodium atom's lifetime in the excited state is given. It is given by delta T, and it is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 8 seconds. The wavelength of the emitted light is given as 589 nanometers. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 power minus 9 meter. If you substitute it, we will have lambda as 589 into 10 power minus 9 meters. Energy is given in the form of electron volts, that is 2.105 electron volts. Since time and wavelength are in SI units, we have to convert electron volts into joules. For that, we need to multiply 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 to given 2.105. Then we will have energy as 3.3722 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Now you can calculate uncertainty in the energy of excited state using the above formula by substituting for h cross and delta t. We will get delta E as 6.5944 into 10 power minus 27 joules. This is the first part of this problem. There is another question asked, as we have to calculate wavelength spread of the corresponding spectral line. In order to calculate that, we need to use Planck's law. Planck's law is given by E is equal to h nu, where nu is the frequency of the spectral line which is emitted whenever sodium atom comes to ground state from the excited state after the lapse of 1.6 into 10 power minus 8 seconds. We know that nu is equal to c by lambda, that is the relation which connects wavelength and frequency for a particular electromagnetic radiation. If we differentiate this, we will get the value delta E is equal to hc divided by lambda square into delta lambda, where we have neglected negative sign because of the non-negative character of lambda, because it has a dimensions of length. Then by rearranging the above equation, we will have wavelength spread delta lambda, that is equal to lambda square divided by hc into delta E. Substituting the values for lambda, delta E, h and c, where c is velocity of light and it is given by 3 into 10 power 8, we will get delta lambda as 1.151 into 10 power minus 14 meters. This is the required wavelength spread of a corresponding spectral line emitted whenever sodium atom transits from excited state to ground state. Dear students, in these two examples, I have calculated one of the uncertainties, that is delta Px in the previous example and delta E in this example. You may be asked to find out delta T as well as delta X. Those type of problems may be asked in your forthcoming examinations. You need to practice these type of problems in order to get better understanding in these concepts. Now, let us solve some of the problems on particle in a one-dimensional infinite square well potential. First problem. Calculate the first two permitted energy levels of electron in a box of 1.5 angstrom wide and infinite height, given h is equal to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second and mass of electron is equal to 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. Let us solve this problem. This question is asked in the year May 2017. For an infinite square well potential or box of length L, the energy eigenvalue is given by E is equal to n square pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square, where n is the order of the energy level, h cross is Planck's constant divided by 2 pi, m is mass of the particle which is inside the infinite square well potential or box, and L is the width of that potential well or length of the potential well. We can write this equation in another manner as E is equal to n square h square divided by 8m L square, where I have substituted for h cross. H cross is equal to h divided by 2 pi. If we substitute h by 2 pi in this place, we will, in the place of h cross square, we will have h square divided by 4 pi square. Pi square gets cancelled. 4 into 2, 8. Then we will get this relation, n square h square divided by 8 ml square. In this case, you need to remember what are the values of n can take. N can take values from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. N cannot take 0. This you should remember. Now we will list out the given data. Given that H is equal to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, M is 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. That means the given particle is electron, and L, width of the box or width of the infinite square well potential, is 1.5 angstroms. Angstroms is 10 power minus 10 meter. Then L becomes 1.5 into 10 power minus 10 meter. We are asked to find out first two permitted energy levels of electron. We have already noticed that N can take values from 1. Then the first two permitted energy levels are corresponding to values of N as 1 and 2. Now let us solve one by one. When n is equal to 1, E is equal to E1 and n is equal to 1. If we substitute it, then we will get first permitted energy level as E1 is equal to 1 square h square divided by 8 m L square, or it is equal to h square by 8 m L square. If we substitute for m, L and h, we will have the value of E1 as 2.6795 into 10 power minus 18 joules. If we want to convert this E1 value in terms of electron volt, then we have to divide this value by 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Then we will have E1 in terms of electron volts as 16.726 electron volts. This is the value of first permitted energy level for an electron in an one-dimensional box of width 1.5 angstrom and infinite height. Now let us go to solve second permitted energy level value. For that we have to substitute N as 2. We will get E2 as second permitted energy level. If you substitute N is equal to 2, it becomes 2 square, that is 4, 4 h square by 8 ml square. But we have E1 as h square by 8 ml square. In the right hand side of E2, we have h square by 8 ml square. In the place of h square by 8 ml square, we can substitute E1. That means E2 becomes equal to 4 into E1. Therefore, if you multiply 4 to value of E1, we will get E2. That is, E2 is equal to 4 into 16.726 electron volts. Therefore, we get E2 is equal to 66.9045 electron volts. Students, we have calculated first two permitted energy levels of electron in an infinite square well potential. Let us solve next problem. A particle is confined to one dimensional box of length 10 power minus 14 meter. Calculate the lowest energy and also the next two energy eigenvalues of the particle in electron volts, given H is equal to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second and mass of the particle is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. This question is asked in the year May 2019. Let us solve this problem. For an infinite square well potential or box of length L and energy eigenvalue is given by E is equal to n square pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square. As previously said, in the place of h cross, I have substituted h by 2 pi. We will get E as n square h square by 8m L square, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. Given that H is equal to 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, mass has 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg, length is given as 1 into 10 power minus 14 meters. Now, the lowest permitted energy level corresponds to N is equal to 1, that is, E1 is equal to 1 square H square by 8 ml square, or it is equal to H square by 8 ml square. If you substitute HML in this equation, we will have E1. By calculating, we get E1 as 3.2862 into 10 power minus 13 joule. In the question, we are asked to find out energy in terms of electron volts, so that we have to divide this value by 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 joules. If we do that and calculate it, we will get E1 as 2051322 electron volts, or in the powers of 10, if we write, we will get E1 as 2.0513 mega electron volts. Mega means 10 power plus 6. Now let us calculate next two higher energy levels. For that, we have n is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3. First one, n is equal to 2. For that, as in the previous case, if you substitute n is equal to 2, we will have the number 4 here. H square by 8 ml square is common, that is E1. Therefore, we will have 4 into E1 as E2. If you substitute it for 4 E1, we will get E2 as 8.205 mega electron volts. Next one. Second excited state is n is equal to 3. E3 is equal to 9 E1. Since we substitute 3 here, 3 square becomes 9. 9 h square by 8 ml square. For h square by 8 ml square, we can substitute it as E1. Therefore, we will get E3 as 9 into E1. Now, substituting for E1, we will get E3 as 18.459 mega electron volts. Dear students, in these two examples, I have calculated energies of ground state and two excited states, that is E1, E2, E3. You are asked to find out L in some problem, or you may be asked to find out N, the order of the energy level, in some other problem. You need to exercise these in order to get better understanding.